It's Friday. Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. Ba-da-da-da. Bet you my singing's so good that we're gonna get flagged by YouTube's auto piracy thing, and they're gonna mute this video, and it's gonna be for the best. Really? They flagged you for snorting tartaric acid?
That's weird.
Hello.
Hello.
Mint powder.
Hello. Okay, we are ready to start. I hope you're ready to listen. If you're not ready to listen, Yili, well, I don't know what to say.
Except you should be listening.
Yeah.
Yeah, you should be. Listen to me.
To I am the captain me. Now.
I think the viewers could do with the briefest of recaps.
Oh, where's my note?
I don't think your spot could do with the briefest of recaps.
We just
too.
Wing it.
According to my notes that I definitely took all myself. Holy shit, these are just notes from lectures. You know. According to my notes, the spectrum of care was covered by Mork, who covered preventative care. Thok covered primary care. Eleanor covered secondary care, which is acute care in the case of inpatient. I'm keeping on going. Gosh. Some more notes. Wait. 176. Nope, that's not. Oh my goodness. I found them. I found what we're talking about.
You know what you need? Like a separate book for your D&D notes. Just
it
gotta
is.
Chuck
it's
it out
it's a different page. Not written on the same page or anything. That would be silly.
Of course it would be.
That would be nuts. Okay, so according to my notes, you guys fought a thing, an ice golem, an ice golem, whilst you were just approaching the town of Oyavigatan. The ice golem threw some popsicle people at you, and you fought them off bravely, the popsicle people and the golem. Pargon throwing pistachio nuts. Shells, sorry, no nuts. No nuts were thrown in the making of this.
Coup!
You gotta be worried.
You guys came across...
You owe me some pistachios, Thok, you bastard.
A group of frozen people in the wall of the ice surrounding Oyavigatan. Two of you stayed behind to hack open the ice and try and get some information after spotting two small pouches that you assumed might have some parchment inside. So that was Thok and Pargon, I believe, stayed behind, yeah?
Mm-hmm. What?
To break the ice?
And Mork.
Thok and Mork.
Thok and Mork.
Right. Yeah. Thok and Mork. Jesus, Thok and Christ.
I talked to the chief who happened to be Australian instead of whatever the ice
hunter. No, it wasn't the chief, it was the shaman.
Yeah,
oh yeah, that's right.
You guys met the townsfolk.
We met the town, yes.
The ice hunters that were in this town. And after the shaman got you guys all separate from the townsfolk, he revealed himself to be a man by the name. Fuck, he didn't write his name down. I can't remember his name. What was his name?
Dude, you can tell
that's
us.
That's the worst thing to forget to write.
You can literally tell us any name.
Oh my god, yes.
No.
But if someone were to watch this.
I wrote shaman.
Yeah, that's not a name. You wrote, fuckwitch shaman can speak properly. God damn it. If someone's going to be watching this, no one watches this. Who am I kidding? But if someone were watching this start to finish, they'd be like, hey, that shaman's name is this. And then the next episode, they'd be like, but actually.
Does Yili know? Ask Yili.
Yili,
what was the...
You were paying attention a week ago. What was the name of this character? So anyway,
homework for us.
After talking with you guys and discovering that there was no large group of people come to take out the rest of this dragon.
The rest of this dragon.
Well, this dragon,
yeah,
I should say.
Only half of it there.
Yili said, how would I know? Well, Yili's our only viewer, so I'm just going to make up a name, because if Yili doesn't remember, it doesn't matter.
His name was...
Unimportant.
Yearly Thoris.
Frosty boy.
Yearly Thoris Rex.
Yearly Thoris Rex.
Yep. Hang on. Is the stream being uploaded to YouTube?
Oh yeah, definitely. Are you gonna go research for us?
Yeah.
Fantastic, good stuff. Okay, so anyway, you guys discussed with him that the dragon was all powerful. He was very upset at the lack of your ability or perceived lack of your ability to deal with dragons, but yeah.
Did he actually say that? I think he was just disappointed at the fact there's only five of us.
Yeah, he was like, the rest of your group is coming! And then two of you rock up from the ice wall. And this ice wall, you guys had got the paper out of the dwarf, and you'd found something written on it in Dwarven that I don't think you understood. Had you translated it?
That's correct. We found a second piece of paper that had... Oh, wait, no.
There was... Oh, no, you're right. Yeah. Sorry, something written in Dwarven that the townsfolk... No, it wasn't in Dwarven. It was in Common. That the townsfolk... they've been really nice and hospitable. And just today, we're going off to have a dinner thrown for us outside the edge of town. And you gathered that... That was the last thing written, because it was like a journal entry
you'd found on this guy. Yeah, I remember when we got the popsicle dwarf open.
Yes.
Found the note that had some fucking dragon's name on it or some shit.
I've got the dragon's name.
Arathator? Arathator?
Yeah.
Arathator.
Okay.
Yeah, we're working on the other bit.
Makes Glazeal look like a newt.
Pretty much. Laughable comparable powers.
Oh no,
so,
we only won by basically cheating.
We'll just do it. Oh fuck.
It's not cheating, it's being resourceful.
Okay. You're right.
Yeah.
His name is...
Da-da-da.
Bumper Clyde.
My YouTube is way too low res for me to actually see it. Osno Patrice, also known as Iluk.
Ah, Iluk was his shaman name to the village people, that's right.
Yes, yes, and Osno Patrice.
So his name is Osno.
Yes.
That's it.
Glad I remembered. What is the group doing? You guys, I think, had just met up all together.
We're discussing our plan to deal with the dragon.
I believe you're getting stoned and finishing off the last of the pistachios.
Yeah, that's accurate.
Clutch a little vape noise in the background there.
Oh, so mate, you want me to crank it up?
In like an igloo bar or something.
Yeah, yeah.
Right now?
Oh, we're in
tents. Yeah, it's not even an igloo bar, it's just a hovel.
Ugh.
Were you not here last time?
No, she wasn't.
No, she wasn't.
She's just appeared.
You're on the boat.
All right, well, I'm hanging out with my big dogs.
Oh, bro! I bet there's some important story developments happening, bro! Says Chef on the boat to Iona. Perhaps you should stay here whilst I stay... Oh, no, you should fuck off whilst I stay here. That sounds like a good idea, bro.
Aye, good plan, big man. I wink him and off I go.
And you see the camera's looking back over your shoulder as it's pulling out, and you just see Chef standing on the boat. Bye-bye! As you continue on with a determined look on your face.
As a pair of polar bear cubs come up and maul him to death.
No.
Well,
accurate.
No, they love you. Because you forced it to be your friend with magic.
True.
No. All right, so what are you guys doing right now? What are you trying to do right this second?
I forget what we're doing.
We're planning
to try to make a plan. Stoned in the village.
That's what I'm doing specifically.
What?
I'm smoking like salvia or whatever that shit's called.
Oh, didn't I do something really stupid just at the end of the session? I have a.
Mate, that doesn't narrow anything down, really.
Yeah. I was even doing something just at the end of the session, but I don't remember what it was. Who looked in his gown at his dick?
Sock.
What?
Sock, wait, what?
What the fuck is going on?
Sock went to give him a
knocked over his gown?
It was a loincloth, so there's no actual way to give him a wedgie.
Oh, fuck did that, I think.
Yes.
Oh,
Sock's rammed on his hang dang.
Yeah, so Sock just gave him a wedgie by way of his penis or something. I'm not sure.
That's all right. It sounds about right.
Just exposed the poor man.
Why people are living in an icy tundra wearing loincloths, I don't know.
So just because you guys are floundering, as a group, your goal right this second is to uncover more about the Drakehorn, which you've covered. You've tracked to this this iceberg, this town, and it appears that there's a dragon that's made its home here. These ice hunters are fearful of this dragon, that much is obvious.
Did we ask also about the Dracorn?
No, you hadn't asked him about the dragon. You'd asked him about the dragon, though. Or rather, he had pulled you aside and asked you about the dragon as soon as you had showed that you had killed a dragon before. I think one of you... Actually, no, that's right. You did see... Someone was seen going into the tents after talking amongst themselves, after you guys headed off with the shaman. Some of the villagers were seen looking over and then going into the larger tent. But no one had sort of explored that avenue at all.
Are we going to have to do like what's it called?
Charge genocide?
Yeah, that one. Are we going to have to do a genocide now?
I mean, that's up to you.
Okay, so I go out. No, because Thok and I wouldn't have been there to see those people going into the other team. Because it was Pargon there.
Correct. And you guys are only just arrived. But you do still have the note. I think you needed to discuss with the group and possibly Osno about this note.
Dracorn. Oh.
And the Dracorn.
Knock, knock, knock. It's me, Iona. Hiya. Oh, that's a weird time. I'll just snuggle up right here next to you. Hey. Oh, okay. Now I'm in the game.
Yeah, it's like how you slowly transition from, like, you know, your accent to Irish.
Okay, it's not Irish.
It's Welsh.
Is it Welsh? I don't know. It sounds Irish to me.
It's just a pretty mild Scottish accent.
What? Talk about Hello? Iona.
So is everybody else, Paco.
You know what? We're fucked. Dragon's gonna kill the shit out of us. So
Pagan
so
plops down
these villages out of
this
misery.
This smoke, whatever it is a bit tougher than he thought, and he feels overwhelmed with feelings of depression.
Bullshit, man.
Suit ephedrine.
It's over, man. It's over.
Game over.
Let's go kill everyone.
Since you're still lacking direction.
Someone who knows about the horn. Yeah, ask him about the horn.
You've even said, like, we just need to talk to them about the horn.
Yeah, but Mork wouldn't know, so I was like, someone smart can ask that. No? Okay.
Nope. Mork pipes up and says, what about the horn?
Yep, Mork just breaks character randomly.
Wait, horn. Yeah.
This weed is taking on to everyone. They're all fucked.
Everyone's got a contact high, I guess.
The entire group just sits down and sort of stares at the floor next to Pargon and goes, you know, he's probably right. It's kind of worthless. So, everyone roll a new character. And
So let's go kill everybody and then we'll feel better.
Okay, well,
killing is the only way I can feel now.
That's Dracorn, right? Is that correct, Dracorn?
Yes.
Dracorn?
Yeah. It's like D-R-A-A-K, but I assume it's Dracorn. It is in my world.
Dracorn.
It's like you're saying giraffe. It's the giraffe horn.
Giraffe horn.
The horn of a giraffe. Find it.
Okay. I don't think they're not called horns. They're called something else.
Oh my god, Pagan.
I just want to go murder everyone now because this is losing steam.
Hey, I mean, we did ask about the drink. Yeah, see, there you go. There.
What's a Dracorn? I don't care what that is.
You mean the Dracorn?
I can tell you what an ossicone is, though. That's what.
It's at this point that Osno begins to talk to you about the reason he's in this village. And it comes from this conversation that he was part of the group. He was traveling with Macath to study and find out about the Dracorn. And he doesn't have anything more to offer than you, except that this is where they followed all sort of information they had about the Drakhon back. Fuck! Sorry, excuse me, everybody that had to put up with that. It was then that he was captured following some ice hunters. And he had to pretend, so he had some understanding of the language. He was a part interpreter for this team. And he pretended that he had magical ability and that he was an important religious figure for this tribe. So it was over some time that he managed to gain their trust as a shaman, and is now highly revered amongst the village in the last few years. This is a couple of years back that Macath got cut off as well. The last he heard of Macath was he'd been going inside or into this ice area and or this ice tower, and I assume one of you points out to him, "How do you get inside?" And he says, "There are tunnels that head from the main building of Oya Vigatan, the central hub, down inside into the spire."
How does this relate to the Drakhon?
Says it was where we were, where we were pursuing it when I was captured, right, and where I last saw right. Macath heading.
All that stuff about your past is just, okay, gotcha.
It's relevant, because that's where Macath was heading when he last saw him.
Where is this?
He looks at you and says, you're on an iceberg.
Aye, but fucking pick a direction. Like, what are you talking about?
I don't understand what you're asking.
Hey, what did you...
He said a spire and a place?
Yep, so you guys are within a ring of ice. Sorry, I just remembered you weren't here. So you guys are within a ring of ice that surrounded the side you entered, the town of Oya Vigatan, which is a small ice hunting community, if you like 20 so buildings, or yurts and huts and things. In the center of this circle bit is a huge ice spire that sticks up into the sky, bigger than any building you've ever seen, any naturally formed ice spire you've ever come across in any travel or story. So he doesn't look at you strangely, jeez, because you would have seen that, and I've now described it to you. So I assume you don't ask it again.
Hey, it was fucking snowy outside. It didn't see. Hey.
Of course.
What happened to your accent?
It's very early in the morning.
The
other guys.
Yeah, the other guy.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah, really.
You have to do the accent.
No, because
us cunts and stuff.
No, I specifically told you what his conversation consisted of, so I didn't have to do the accent.
Yeah, but you were just talking.
I say.
Shut up.
You have to do the accent.
Yeah, you're doing like a morph voice.
Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Do it. Do it, man. I'm injured. You have to do it for me.
I mean, if we're not worth it, that's fine. Just say so.
Yep.
Oh!
He's just going to say we're not worth it.
Cut me deep, man.
Oh.
That's right. The pressure's on now, so I'm not going to do it.
All right. Which one's the
what if we say no pressure?
Tent that the tunnel leads under then, pal?
Sorry, could you repeat that? No, I didn't hear.
Sorry, which building did you say the tunnel went under from here?
He tells you that it was the center building of the town.
The one where everyone went...
Yeah, basically it looked like the town hall, or the town gathering building, I should say. And it's where some people were seen looking at you and heading down. Or heading into, I should say. Keep giving away that they were heading down.
Are we allowed into these tunnels?
He shakes his head and says it is forbidden.
Right.
Let's go.
Come on, talk.
Yeah.
Rendering time.
All right, let's go fuck them up.
What?
I agree.
Yeah,
Iona just agrees with wanton murder. Excellent.
She sounds tired.
Why?
She traveled all the way here, remember?
She's got wings. She flies.
Yeah, they're all tiring. They're tiny little wings.
But you are a tiny little person.
Well, exactly. I'm extra tired then.
Well, like,
if it's forbidden to go in the tunnels, we might as well just let ourselves in. Because they're not going to let us otherwise.
Well, let's do a wee perception check outside the tent, eh? And hear, see if there's anyone inside. Iona turns into an Arctic fox. He does it. Animorph, best game ever.
Are you sure that you don't want to be a killer whale again? Because I think that would be wonderful.
In the middle of a tent.
That's would be
just collapse the island. It would be great. Thank you. Thanks in advance.
Don't be fucking collapsing the island around here, cunt!
Yes!
Yeah.
I woke up for a reason.
All right, that's those two things.
Do you guys want to hear my George of the Jungle noise to make you wake up?
No.
Yes.
Maybe we could just like sleep because it's getting pretty late.
Maybe. Oh, what time is it? Yeah, that's a good point.
6:30 p.m.
Go to bed, Alicia.
30 p.m.
Yeah.
I actually meant Spike, but he's just not talking to us anymore.
It's 6:30 for me too. I'm in the same time zone. I'm actually 3 feet away from her.
Yeah.
I actually meant engage fucking mom.
That's what I was talking about, but that's fine.
He's already head sleep too. He came home and fell asleep.
Let's our
It's getting to the mid of the afternoon.
Okay.
You guys could take a short rest. You don't need a long one, so don't be ridiculous.
I was just wondering if it was nighttime or not, because we've done a lot.
Coming up to, but it's like maybe 3-4 o'clock. You don't actually know quite how far away sundown is. On your traveling throughout the boat, it was very long days and very short darkness, very short nights.
Arctic Circle and all that. That jet.
Sock and I could probably do with a short rest.
I'll give you a short rest.
Yeah.
Considering we got punched the fuck up.
Yeah, there you go.
So spend any hit dice you'd like to. You guys can spend hit dice to recover hit points. I'm just gonna explain as things happen for people that give a shit.
Okay.
Very nice. Chef's probably gonna spend some hit dice too.
Nah, damage. Fuck that guy.
I had his apology this time.
Nah, people should be used to it by now. Why is... Oh, that's a death saving throw. Why would I roll that? That's ridiculous.
On the boat, shit just dies.
He didn't turn up. He dies 3 times. Ah. 4, 4, 1.
Wait, what?
Pargon death! So Chef... I mean, he needs to spend all his hit dice. He's terrible.
I'm alive!
A long rest last episode, you said. I listened to
him. No, you're right! He did!
Recording.
You and him, so you should actually have a long rest too, and I'll give that to you.
Yeah.
Oh, so she gets a long rest, bitch.
Wow.
Yes.
I'm ready
for
my initiative.
Salty.
Rest. Long
I'm gonna
rest.
Start skipping a week whenever I want a long rest because damn.
Or you could just take a long rest on the times you need it.
All the time, every time.
No, you're like literally short rest based. Don't complain.
Right. Okay. Well, I'm gonna turn. Well, these jokers are having a little sleeperoo. I'm gonna turn into a Arctic fox if possible and like have a little skulk around the camp.
So just another animal they probably hunt for food.
Yeah, I know, but what else am I gonna be? A big
I'm not just gonna steal that idea, but literally predatory animals inside a hunting community's village will probably result.
Alright, in that case, fuck it. I'm turning into a big Arctic wolf and I'm gonna wait for them guys to come out so that I can do advantage on hearing checks.
You know what?
Is my plan,
go for it.
So we can
go
hear what's going on in the tent.
I mean, could you just like turn into a mouse. Roar,
you become a big Arctic wolf and sit inside the hut and listen.
Yeah, I'm listening.
What are you trying to listen for?
I'm just trying to work out where people are in, like, terms of my smells and my hears, like a wolf would.
Do you want to, like, echolocate everyone in the village as a wolf?
No. I just want to, like, see roughly where the people are.
She should get an advantage yes. on her perception because she's good at hearing.
She does get advantage on her perception based on sight and smell. But you don't have echolocation skills. You can hear that outside of the hut that you're in. Go ahead and roll perception, and I'll
with tell you advantage.
With advantage, yep.
Sorrow, I'll just find it.
Yeli's got the right idea. You should have turned into a magic snow rat.
Or just walked out of the tent. Had a look. I mean.
Well, I basically did, but I'm a wolf doing it, so suck my tits.
You are walking out of the tent now as a wolf.
Oh, no.
Okay.
I'm just poking my nose out the tent and having a little listen and a look. I'm with the party. It doesn't
you know what?
Matter.
Go for your life, Dan.
So you stick your head out of the tent. Do you have a sniff and a whiff? And you prick your little ears up. And you can gather there's probably at least 30, 40 people around. You hear some footsteps crunching over snow within sort of 30, 40 feet. You can gather there's about 10 people. And then you hear some feet on tough ice, more like a soft slapping noise, like a leather feet on a soft a hard surface, more than the crunch of snow underfoot. And you hear what sounds to be two or three people walking on this surface.
All valuable information. I take my wolf's head back into the tent and I sulk. And I go, woof, woof, woof.
That was legitimate information.
I bark 30 times.
No one hears a thing.
Okay. Do any of the villagers hear that?
No, they're too busy crunching on snow underfoot.
Oh, right, it's really loud crunching.
They won't be goaded into attacking a wolf. Jeez.
Okay, so there's three folk on the ice and a bunch of people in the snow. I don't know what that means.
To be fair, you rolled a 19. It sounds like maybe the steps that were walking on solid ice were like heavy enough that it sounded like someone was walking up or down stairs.
Okay.
Oh, so they're going through that cave.
Yeah.
The GM shrugs.
Okay. Okay, well, I do an arrow in the snow towards the tent that we might be going to.
Oh, you mark your territory in an arrow shape?
Yeah. It was just hard because I'm a female wolf, but I do it.
Just squat and drag your dog.
Why
out
do you have to be
ground?
A female wolf? That's sexist. Because
she's a girl?
Yeah, but Muriel was a female bear. So.
Well, and it's my choice.
So
maybe we don't want to have a dick.
Yeah, maybe we don't want to have a wolf dick. I want a wolf vagina.
This is a strange conversation.
Wow. Weird places.
So you head outside the hut and you start drawing in the snow with your wolf bum, just dragging along the ground. Some villagers walk past. They're used to having wolf pets, but they look over and show concern that perhaps you have worms. And in fact, one comes over and attempts to lift up your tail to check your behind once you finish.
Snap at his hand.
You bite his hand?
No, just snap it like the end.
Oh, just like a nip. Like a... And he lets go and says, walks off grumbling.
And then I wink at the party.
Inside the tent.
Who aren't out there.
I stick my head in the tent, wink, and then head towards where we might be going.
We'll see you in an hour.
The wolf sets off alone. One might say, a lone wolf.
No.
Don't.
Fuck me.
Oh, yelling space through the wall. I didn't even know if it was called
that. That wasn't for that, but it totally does. So, what is the group doing? The wolf is walking off towards the building.
We're having a short rest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are
we going to
yeah,
go down?
Your short rest is done. You spent your dice. Fuck.
Oh.
Are we going to go follow. Down this tunnel?
Yeah, I'll go follow.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll go follow the wolf.
Okay.
Here, wolfie, wolfie.
And I'm hungry.
Now you guys start heading off towards this tent, and the shaman's like, fucking, you just head off there, right? I don't even give a shit. And he sits down and continues to smoke a bowl. When you get close to the tent... when you get close to the tent, however, there seems to be two ice hunters that are standing outside of it. And as you approach, they sort of tense up and you see them, and they're both gripping spears in their hands, and... they're quite big. They look very capable. They look like capable warriors. And as you try to step into the building with your wolf in front, one of them sort of growls and kicks out towards the wolf and then turns to you and says in like a garbled, no!
The dude on the boat, he taught me some phrases, right?
Yep. What would you like to try and say?
I'd just like to say, like, friendly and then
look and loud.
Horn.
Friendly.
Look for horn. Tunnel. Shaman.
Roll me a performance check.
Common phrases, though, are they?
No, not at all. Roll me a performance check, please.
He's going to be like.
Friendly.
Like friendly.
Horny.
Yeah, friendly and horny. That's what Fark is.
Friendly, I'm horny. Can I see your body?
Well, we'll see what he says after this performance check.
Oh, no.
Oh, somebody want to throw me an inspiration?
Have an advantage.
Thank you.
Gosh, yeah, you guys asked for inspiration on the most mundane shit. It's great.
Well, we wouldn't use it for anything important, right?
No, of course
pretty
not.
Much.
You always forget when you're fighting things. Oh, my goodness.
Well, he didn't burst out laughing, so that's always a good sign.
Yeah, he said, oh my goodness.
He rolled on the tower. So, he seems to understand what you're saying. Kind of. He does give you a strange look. But then he repeats, no! And sort of gestures away and starts speaking in a huge 30-second monologue. And you catch a couple of words like no and danger and kill and not allowed.
Like, we don't care.
These few phrases you learned was like an intensive language course that you sort of keep up with. But
I cast suggestion on him and just say yes?
Does suggestion require you to know the language? Or just that they need to
understand? Well, they have to understand me, so I figure the word yes would be understand. He's like no, and I'm like, how about yes?
I'll allow it. What's the save there?
There we go. 16.
You cast it on Thok.
Wisdom.
You suggest Thok, yes.
Wait, what? No.
Thok says,
Oh, I see.
Hey, no, that's not who I do it
Why?
On.
What? Stay away from me, son of a bitch.
There.
Thok says, horny, look under clothes, let me in. And sucks
this.
Okay. So you suggest this guy, and he rolls an 8, and his wisdom modifier is not high enough. So he looks confused, and then he stands back and he says, yes! And he moves out of the way. But his friend next to him said, like, what? What's going on? You can tell from his gesturing and his surprised tone of voice. And, he attempts to bar your passage. Then he shouts out something that Thok recognizes as demon or devil and rolls initiative. Go ahead and roll initiative.
Putting on the mask and rolling initiative.
Hello.
Show these fuckers a devil. Yep. But in a few turns.
Is that what devil looks like?
Oh my god, really this slow. Is wrong, guys.
Oh, dude.
Holy crap.
Did you use a wolf, Spike?
Oh, yeah, I'll give you a wolf. Hang on. I'm just going to give you normal wolf, okay?
You're not in a fit state to lead the charge, are you, Caelan?
I'm not drunk enough for this.
Have you rolled your initiative,
Wimmy? What's your C element, Wimmy?
Two.
Two, okay. The direwolf is CR1, so I'll give you that.
Six.
Oh, hang on. No. Close that one. I'll give you the one that works on the combat tracker.
Sick.
Fucking sick, mate.
There you go. That should do. You should now be able to
hungry like the me.
Roll attacks okay. And stuff.
Hungry like the me.
Hungry like the you. So he goes to the book where his stat blocks are, and Ice Hunter.
You realize this is going to be noisy. We're going to have to murder the whole town now, right?
Yep.
And he rolled. He didn't roll a 19.
Maybe we could like push him into the tunnel. So
yeah, that's a really good idea.
Yeah.
We need to push them into this tent and like murder them like in a movie.
So it's obvious to all of you that he's getting ready to attack, and you all have a chance to react because he rolled a 3 for his initiative. He goes like a menacing move as if he's ready to strike one of you, and you all get a turn before he does.
Especially me.
Especially you.
But not Iona.
Oh, no. Point. Does she have ambuscade?
Oh, she rolled a 4. That's still higher than him.
Good point. Rosalind, you get ambuscade.
Yeah.
So before everyone. You don't need to like click anything. You just have a turn before everyone else.
Oh, okay.
That you can only use for the attack or hide action, I think it was.
Yes.
Yeah, attack or hide.
Yeah.
So you're not currently up in melee range of him, so you can shoot him, or you can attempt to hide behind one of your friends.
I'm gonna punch him in the face.
You're not.
No,
punch him with a bow.
Okay.
What's wrong? Why are
Suck's just angry that you usurped his first turn.
I am. I'm very angry that I'm not leading this charge.
That's not very often Suck tops the initiative.
Sure.
Yeah. Where am I? There we go. Alrighty.
Is there a map?
So.
Theater of the mind,
what's
buddy.
What's the difference between my longbow and my shortbow?
One's long and one's short. One of them has a +1, one of them doesn't. I know which one I would choose.
The shortbow.
Yes, because it doesn't have a +1. Don't want that getting in the way.
Mm.
So you hit him. Now, before you roll damage, you get sneak attack. And so apply that. And because you're... It's on your actions at the bottom. Before you roll damage, even after the sneak attack, hold shift... Because, oh no, he's not surprised. You do not get critical hit. Okay, so you just get your sneak attack damage.
Okay, I have first sneak attack.
Okay, now roll damage. And the arrow, before he even gets his spear up, he's not dead. Before he gets his spear up, you've already unleashed a shot. It's straight into his chest and he staggers back, heavily wounded. But he continues coming on and out his Doc's turn.
Push him into the tent.
The other Ice Hunter is there beside him. It is looking like he will most likely attempt to help his friend. The suggestion doesn't stop him being an enemy.
He just feels yes.
He feels yes.
Yes.
Feels very yes.
Can I try it?
No.
Say...
Sorry, what?
No.
What would you like to do?
Just murder him and drag the body in.
No, what would you like to do?
Drunk.
You don't have to just kill him.
Wait.
Stretch your imagination.
I want to say in Ice Hunter
Iluit.
Language. Iluit? Yeah. Stop. No fight. And I'm going to put my hands up. Between me and the party and the other guys, the big guys.
Roll me don't a persuasion with a disadvantage. He has got a massive arrow sticking out of his chest. And he is nearly dead. he continues to push on. He shows no sign of stopping.
Damn.
genocide time.
Actually, his friend is there. You can see him. Neither does his friend, who is looking like he's getting ready to attack.
I was hoping I rolled double 20s.
Okay, you didn't. You rolled a 3.
All right. I guess that's my turn then.
Okay.
Well, I mean, I can't attack or anything, right?
I could say that use your bonus action to attempt to stop him. You can, or to like attempt to stop combat. You can still have your action.
All right.
Oh yeah.
And I'm gonna attack him against my better wishes.
Ooh, low AC, brilliant.
Yep, very low AC.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
You put your hand up to tell him to stop, and he just shows no signs, so you are given no choice but to cleave him down in one fell blow, and he collapses in a heap on the ground.
You're welcome.
Swing at his buddy.
I do have an extra attack, so I guess I will.
Punch his friend in the face.
Dude, you didn't give his mate an option.
Ah, oh, fuck, I missed.
After seeing his friend cut down, the remaining ice hunter is more able to react and dodges out of the way of your blow. Go ahead.
My turn.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
And you hit. And you still get your sneak attack because one of your friends is within 5 feet. And he takes an arrow straight to the neck and dies.
Is critical heavier than heavy?
Yes, critical is they are critically wounded. And he catches an arrow in the net, a neck, before he can cry out for help.
Ooh,
and everything's over fast enough. You guys are quiet for a moment. It appears no one has noticed.
Can we push the bodies into the tent out of sight, please?
Sure. You immediately, as soon as your arrow is let loose, you just move forwards and begin dragging the bodies through the tent. Does anyone else help?
I'll help.
Okay, so the two of you start pulling these bodies through the tent. As you pull through, you slump the bodies on the floor, stand up to congratulate each other for a job well done, and turn around to see three guys standing there, these horrified looks on their faces, weapons in hand, and one of them shouts, you guys... Roll initiative, I'm sorry.
Wait, is it not the same initiative?
No, this is new combat. The combat's finished and then you guys have started again.
No, I have spells that can, like, non-violently resolve conflicts and you guys just murder the shit out of everything.
Hey, man, I'll try it.
Buddy.
I fucking try it, alright?
You can try that fucking hard.
Spike, could you give me control of this wolf? It doesn't seem to be working.
What are you trying to do?
Roll initiative, it just rolls it for Iona.
That's because you're not using the wolf's sheet for it?
That
I can't see the initiative.
Oh, no, you're right, there isn't an initiative button on NPCs. I'll roll it for it. It's okay.
Thanks. Do I get my first turn again?
Ah!
Jesus Christ.
I need to tidy up. I just knocked like 30 energy drink cans all over myself.
You just what?
Knocked 30 energy drink cans
all over
myself.
It did
sound like
a lot.
Yeah, you should stop drinking that many energy drinks, to be honest.
It's like a week's worth. It's fine.
He was.
No! Doesn't. No!
Okay.
Mr. Health Professional will tell you, who still drinks it anyway, but not as much as you.
I drink it a lot. That's terrible. Okay, so. You guys, only Thok and Rosalind are currently in the tent, so Mork, you'll come around on next initiative. Actually, everyone will come around on next initiative. The first round of combat is just Thok, Rosalind, and the Ice Hunters, as you all follow in behind a few seconds later. Thok!
Your turn first this time, buddy bear.
Wow. Now the ambuscade
happened? Yep. Yes. Yes, it does. So, Rosalind, ambuscade. Gotta remove that level of fucking ridiculous range here.
Yeah.
Ember,
all
what?
Right, am I melee range?
Yes.
I am? Okay. I can still bow them, eh?
Yes, but it'll be at disadvantage.
That's right then.
Doesn't she have sharpshooter?
Sharpshooter's for cover, not for within 5 feet.
Really?
Yep.
What's the 5 feet? Right.
5 feet would be, I think it's one of the other ones.
Ah, yes, the other ones.
Dan, I have a dagger that says thrown, but then it has a bow picture.
So it's got an ammo counter, because it's a ranged weapon attack. It's what the bow,
oh, is it?
It's what the bow represents.
I can use my sneak attack thing, eh?
Mm-hmm. And you hit for 22 points of damage.
Not finished. Oh, I miss. I'm finished.
You miss. Okay. Thuck, your turn. Crossbow expert, by the way, Jeff.
That's the one I just read.
Oh boy, here I go murdering again.
Don't sound so disappointed, buddy.
Yeah.
I just murdered.
Yeah, there's kind of no way... No way out of talking your way. No way to talk your way out of the. Fuck! I language.
What?
Didn't you just say that guy yelled as well?
This one.
The ice hunter yelled out.
Oh, I don't know. Did I? What was that? Sorry,
you just did.
Yeah, he did. He said demon.
Yes. No. That was the guy outside that said demon, and then attacked the guy inside. Saw you bring the bodies in, and then called out.
Overkill, mate.
So the critical killed the guy, but. You gain... Roll 1d4.
Why did that not count?
What?
One.
God damn it.
Okay, so for the next one round, all of your attacks are at advantage.
I have an extra attack, so...
Oh, yeah.
Why advantage?
Because he criticaled. The thrill of the fight instills you with a fury that provides advantage on all attacks for 1d4 rounds. He's just shit and rolled a 1.
Ah, very nice.
Very, very nice.
Fuck you, guys, that I didn't want to kill, but I'm going to now.
Alright. Rosalind, your turn.
Okay, it's me. How did that go? Net 20.
Stop critical hitting my NPCs! Fuck! How am I supposed to kill you? You kill him, but let me see what the chart is.
I can offhand the next guy, eh? Correct. Hitting him again.
You could have rolled damage twice and taken the best, but it's okay because you exceeded his hit points by 26. Okay, so yes, you can attack the one there. You don't get sneak attack again, though.
I don't.
No, okay. Only once per turn.
Oh, yeah, I touched him a little.
37 points! And then you just sort of, like, slice this guy next to him. Like, yeah, you're next, motherfucker.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
Careful, buddy. That's just me pressing my knife up to his throat, making him bleed a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, we go down to him. And he attempts to defend himself. He doesn't even get pack tactics because you fucking killed everyone. Jesus Christ. And he misses with his attack. And it's a Thuxton. And you guys all burst into the tent after you've heard the cry out. And you guys are now in the initiative roll.
Everyone's dead.
can we hide the bodies after they're dead so we don't have to kill everyone? Right,
I'm going
to
murder the whole town.
No, please.
Wait, I haven't got to punch anything yet.
No, don't. Let's just do the thing.
Mork will just give into a berserk rage and run off into the town.
Mork will fucking not.
Oh,
fight the woman and children.
Oh, wow. We can give some other people a turn now. It still says he's not fine.
What?
I'm sorry, little guys.
He's
I'm
fine.
Sorry.
Mork's turn. You walk in. You see this guy ready to attack.
You should have done more damage, he would have died. Ooh! Oh, there we go.
Nice.
I just pat him on the back like, I think you got him, bro.
So you just walk in and you see that two of them have been cut down, and you just start swinging your warhammer and bludgeoning this guy into a heap of sludge on the ground. And then once the smoke clears, there's nothing left of him, and everyone else is just sitting there sprayed in blood.
Like, we mega overkilled him?
No, it just means if they were doing dying saving throws, it's two failed saving throws. But they're not because they're NPCs.
Oh, God.
I like how I hit on...
hit on everything?
Yep.
Nice.
So are these bodies safe in here, or should we hide them further?
Well, we heard him yell out from outside the tent.
Maybe no one else did.
We killed them pretty quick.
Let's try and make this...
Stop looking over when I'm rolling.
I can't see you.
Rolling.
Can I walk back out of the tent? Around?
Do you want to walk back out?
Yeah.
Okay, you walk out as this this blood apparition looking just heap of mess, and you step out and you see, roll a perception, let me see what you see.
Oh my fucking god.
Why did he go out?
To see if anyone heard us.
Oh my god.
I hear nothing.
Roll it in the tower, please.
Oh, thank goodness.
Damn it. I love being ignorant.
You step outside, and this town, which normally had... You don't think about that. You see no one.
Okay.
I've got a passive perception of 13, by the way, as a wolf. Does that help at all?
Are you passively looking for something?
Yeah, I'm, like, listening.
How do you passively look?
No, but perception means, like... hearing and stuff as well.
Yeah, so passive perception is like if you're not actively looking for something, that's what I'm rolling against when something is hidden from you.
Okay,
so say
like,
you're
I'm
walking along and there's
ears.
A guy that's trying to kill you, instead of you having to say I roll perception every 5 feet just to make sure I'm not randomly throwing a person at you, I just consider that you're always rolling 13 and that anything I'm rolling against is that.
Aye,
for you
well,
to listen out
right
you would still roll
listen.
No, that's okay, you well, rolling a roll now.
All right, well, I'll roll a roll.
Yeah. That's the difference between passive and active. If you're going to listen
there,
for
yeah.
something, you roll. Okay. Oh, would you look at that? It was a 13. you listen out, and you hear no footsteps. You hear no words spoken. You hear nothing. Absolutely silent, except for a small
you
bit of wind.
Okay. I stick my little snoot out the tent and I go, bark, 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 bark.
There's nothing out here. Go back in the tent, Iona.
Bark, bark.
And I wander back in.
Okay. So you guys are now in a tent with, well, 5.5 dead bodies, 4.5 dead bodies.
So what else is this is the place we were sort of pointed
correct.
Towards, right?
Now, you have a look around. You don't need to roll, but you see sort of towards the back of this tent, you see a wooden frame, or not wooden, sorry, a whalebone framed trapdoor that is not there to hide anything, just there to offer coverage. Upon lifting it, you see it goes down into a
tunnel!
Not unnaturally formed. It looks like it's existed here and then has had stairs cut into it. So it's not like a carved out tunnel, but it's like a hole in the ice that has had stairs carved in to allow humans to travel.
Here's our tunnel, guys.
I would like to roll the bodies into the tunnel.
Into the tunnel.
Yeah, because then we can shut the trap doors off. If anybody comes in, it won't be.
What happened the last time you rolled bodies into a thing?
You know what? That was different.
And we got a mop.
Things have changed.
Okay.
Well,
you start
we'll need to fight whatever
rolling the bodies and sort of like scooching the guts across the floor into this hole. And one by one they fall in until there's a 4.5
overkill mop.
Pile of bodies at the bottom of... Well, about 5-6 feet down. The tunnel continues on for about 30 or 40 steps beyond that, and then you see it reach a landing and then continue out of sight. It is well lit. There seems to be light coming down the other end. Not flickering like it's flames, but just light emanating from the other end of the tunnel.
Start traveling?
Let's go.
Yeah.
Okay. With a cursory glance around, you guys continue down the stairs. Does anyone shut the door or do you leave it open?
Shut it.
What do you mean? Oh, the
shut the door!
Intruder, shut the gate! Alright, so you shut the trapdoor behind you and continue into the tunnel.
Is there like a... There's no way to bar it or anything?
Not that you can see. You might be able to fashion something. What do you have in mind to bar it?
Don't trapdoors open upwards?
They do, but you can get something stuck into the inside and try and wedge it around the whalebone somehow. Like tie it down from the inside. You do have a caster. Caster boy!
I think it's helpful.
I don't have any spells for barring.
You could just set it on fire.
You should suggest that the door doesn't open again.
Don't open door!
It is whale bones. It's a type of creature, right?
Speaking of Pargon,
that's how it works.
We're going to have to talk about you cast suggestion on me. I'm not okay with that.
I cast suggestion on Thok and suggest that he be okay with
it. Thok, make a will saving throw. Bloody wisdom.
You fucker.
Wisdom.
I am so glad you said that.
You know what? I'm going to fucking make will saving throw. Fuck you.
Are you going to make it?
Did you make your save?
Wait, is it wisdom? Or...
Wisdom, yep.
What? Okay.
You're fine. You rolled a 19. Why'd you roll it in the tower?
Yeah, suck it. I don't know, because I could.
He's drunk.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
You're still not okay with it.
Fuck you.
A spell slot and a dice roll to tell your friend to go fuck himself.
Alright, I head along the tunnel if we can't
seal. Are you leading the way?
Yeah, with my little snoot on the floor.
With your snoot on the
floor. I put my dragon mask back on.
Okay.
We're not being stealthy anymore, we've just murdered a whole lot of people, so...
Hey, no one's noticed as far as you can tell. There was no one outside, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Plus, like, I don't know, maybe a wolf would elicit less immediate action.
Holy fuck, big map! Holy
oh
shit.
No. Is this a 4K map, bro?
It fucking looks like it.
He like opened it and all you could see was the first letter of what it was called.
Oh fuck.
Yeah.
I don't even see a map.
He hasn't given it to us yet.
Why not?
Remember, I'm in his house.
It's Dan's house.
She's in my house, guys. Don't give her any ideas, Wimmy.
What? Woman power.
Drake off the chains of oppression.
Find the patriarchy! Don't even start, Jeff.
I'm really trying hard to restrain myself right now.
So, you guys continue down these stairs, and the tunnel carries forwards for about 100 feet, and you feel like just keeping aware of the direction you're traveling, you're now somewhere central to the spire, the direction you've moved. When the tunnel suddenly ends, or rather doesn't continue forwards anymore, there is instead a chute heading directly down, and there's a spiral staircase of icy stairs descending quite a ways. And as you walk down, you go down probably a good 100 feet, and you find yourself in this, a piece of map.
Ah, the great grey loading screen.
The great grey loading screen.
Lands.
So, So the chamber you arrive in is empty, except for three bundles of what looks to be rolled up seal skins sitting at the bottom of these stairs. Additionally, there's a single bed with furs piled high on it, and this isn't. Yes, that's all you can see because that's the room you're in. Fuck, stop asking stupid questions. Oh man, I just got the biggest pout.
She's a girl, she can't help it.
There's these furs that are stacked sort of 5-6 high. It's the only bed in the room, it's in the southwest corner. And as you guys are sort of all arriving down the stairs, there's a single coughing that comes from it. And then this sort of breaks into this fit. You can hear someone that's trying to cough up a large amount of shit. It's basically Jeff after he laughs too hard.
Yeah,
it sounds like whoever this is has got a bad case of pneumonia.
Oh dear.
We better go fuck about of their misery.
Yeah, we should kill him.
So we'll talk to him first before we just cut his throat, alright?
I don't have anything sharp. I can't cut his throat. I'll use my hammer.
Excuse me? The woman who decided to shoot the guards with no provocation is telling us to wait to kill people now?
Fox is angry because she killed them before you did.
Hey man, they're the ones who rolled initiative.
Excuse me.
Well, this is true, people.
My parlay.
If you
stood
your fucking
life
out, you would have been able to do
so.
That
as the group argues in the middle of the room about whether or not to kill this person, the furs are sort of pushed back, and you see a small, scruffy looking face. This pale, pasty, white ice hunter. He's the same sort of build, and you recognize him, similar to the other villagers. Looks up, and he sort of, thuck you, you hear him say, "Who are you?" in their language. And then he breaks into a coughing fit again. You can see that he's very sickly, very ill. He looks quite gaunt compared to the ice hunters up on top of the village. And you gather that he's probably been sent down here
to die.
Yeah, to die in peace. Or to die where the rest can't hear him cough.
Or get sick. You know.
Oh, they probably don't give a shit about getting sick. They just don't want to hear him cough all night. Ever watched The Beach? Anyway. but he looks up and he says, "Who are you?" But in,
I'll go over
in Illuic. You walk over?
And, yeah. I'll say we're looking for Horn.
What?
Horn.
So you walk over and tell him you're horny. you try to get out that you're looking for the horn, and he replies in a broken common, and he says, "Has Shaman sent you?"
In the words of Hargon, yes.
Do you? And he sort of like gestures to his throat. He says, and then he says an Illuic word. He says, "Medicine." You understand medicine.
You know what?
Why don't we go ahead?
Pachow! The direwolf turns into a little sweetheart. A pixie, that is.
He goes, and then begins to cough again. And you see him bring up, you know, like a productive chest cough.
I say, I wink at him, I go, fucking, but don't worry.
I'm just take all the wind out of her sails and cast Lesser Restoration on.
Oh!
You made me lose a transform slot.
So,
I give Pargon a high five.
So, poof, you turn into a little pixie, yeah. And you come over and you start to be all caring and get ready, and then Pargon's like, blah, 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 there's a restoration. And then it's
with a mad guitar riff to go with it.
And he begins to breathe freely, and for a few moments he sort of feels his chest, and he takes in some big breaths, and it's clear, and there's no wheeze, and he doesn't cough, and you see this look of pure joy come across his face, and he gets up, and he hugs the pixie.
Yes. Oh, me fucking worries, man. It's easy peasy.
He's gonna make you sick.
He's fine now. He's just been cured.
Easy fucking peasy. What about this horn then?
Do you ask him that?
Here, you scratch. We scratch your pneumonia. We scratch our pneumonia. If you know what I'm saying.
No.
He shrugs and he says, basically, he dare not travel past the ice demons. He describes the ice demons. He also introduces himself. He calls, in common, he points to himself and he says, Mindnitz. Me Mindnitz.
Hi, Mindnitz.
And he nods and he says, I Mindnitz and I Mindnitz.
Hi, Mindnitz. Good to meet you.
And his name's Mindnitz?
His name is Mindnitz.
Does he mean
because that's what he does.
Aww. Oh no, I really, really hate that we killed the guys. I say that
sad, but my name's Mum, because I'm a mum. Get it?
Yeah.
That, yeah.
Rosalind's mother.
Oh. Rosalind's got children.
Yeah. I guess. Right. Two little bastards.
Well, more
I like how she's out murdering absolutely everyone. Taking
I'm
care
doing
of
it for
kid.
My kids! Slash, slash, slash.
I
so they can live a better life.
Can you describe these ice demons? What do they look like?
He begins to describe some things. Can I get a nature check from everyone, please? See if you can recognize his description.
Is he just describing the ice golem from earlier in the day?
No, he's definitely not describing the ice golem. Because remember, that wasn't real.
Nice,
hang on. It was real because it happened. I was there.
Oh,
it
yeah, good point.
I probably saw something, heard something.
So, who got above 18? Oh, Pagan, very nice. Very nice.
Is that Thok roll?
No. Wait, what am I...
No need.
Sorry, what?
Thok, doesn't matter. Someone's already got it.
Fuck are you, I'm rolling.
Thok's like, what's this guy talking about? What the fuck is he talking about? Hey.
I don't fucking know.
What's going on? Hey. He describes an ice troll. And Pagan, you know a little bit about ice trolls. You know that they share... regenerative abilities, much like their land troll brethren. You've only heard and not encountered them, so you don't know much else about them. But ice trolls.
Oh shite! We saw one of them at the entrance to this tunnel.
No,
you fucking
you
went
don't.
Mental.
Now,
it killed like 5 guys. Jesus Christ!
Of more interest to the party, as he continues after describing them. To say that some other ice hunters have been down and gone into the caves ahead. And he tells you that it is likely he has gone to tell the ice master that you are here in their village.
No! Someone like grapple
him. What?
What?
They're already
Someone's
gone.
Come ahead! You should grab him! You motherfucker!
Walking off to go get someone.
No,
no.
That's not at all what I said.
Oh.
He said some ice hunters.
Get off Facebook.
Yeah. I just looked over and she's totally on Facebook.
I wasn't when he was talking actually. Just then.
You should have taken that as your excuse. Because now you have no reason to not have heard that. I was listening clearly when I didn't listen clearly at all. So he said some other ice hunters had gone down and were likely warning, he says, the Ice Master, which you can assume is Arathator the dragon, and that the creatures in the cave and the Ice Master are likely aware that you are going to make your way down here eventually.
Not for much longer.
What?
Okay.
Are you...
They won't be aware for much longer.
Oh, right. Not that you're not going to be down here. Are you leaving? Yeah.
Amander, what do you think about the Ice Master?
What?
I ask Netmender how he feels about this Ice Master.
He shakes his head and says, who is this Netmender?
His name is Mendnet, you.
Oh, shit. Well, mend that. What do you think about this Ice Master?
I don't just mend one net and stop.
Vital fucking detail is straightened out. What does he think?
He shrugs. I just mean it.
Right.
Men.
You're awfully helpful for somebody that we just made you keep alive.
Yeah, I mean, that's why he's so
helpful. Extremely helpful.
Yeah.
We made
you sound like you wouldn't want to be kept alive. Yeah. He is being helpful. But he doesn't know a lot. Like, he doesn't go into the tunnels himself. And he's... Well, he's in this very entrance, and he's been sent there to die by his friends in the village.
By Ice Master, do you mean Arthur? What's his name?
Arathator?
Arathator.
He nods and he puts his arms up as if wings and he says, yes, Ice Master.
Do we kill him now?
Let's not go down this tunnel.
He points to his mouth and he says, controls the ice with but his voice.
I vote we don't go down this tunnel and we leave.
Or we kill another dragon.
That sounds good to me.
I kind of feel like I should remind you that apparently this guy is like Glazeal. If Glazeal was actually good crack. At being a dragon. Yeah.
High on crack.
If this was Glazeal on HGH. Well,
we're up here for the horn, so.
DGH.
We don't even know where the horn is.
Steroids. I look at the outside, but what about the horn? Do you know what a horn is?
HGH is human growth hormone, which is different than steroids.
Same thing, whatever, fuck.
The horn.
You did ask about the horn. Sorry.
I did, I'm like.
I was just waiting for everyone to get out their conversations. He shakes his head and says he hasn't seen it, but they have been hearing it sounding. He isn't sure if it comes from down here or if they've just heard it, but it sounds very loud and very close.
All right, big man. Listen, don't go back the way we came from. It's very dangerous.
Okay. Yeah, we killed everyone.
He looks, you're killed?
Who? Oh, they were killed. We don't know what by. It's very dangerous back there. You just have a lovely wee sleep. And I wink at Paragon and like gesture my head.
Hey, Paragon, I don't know what you're talking about.
And kills him.
I don't use bows. Bolts.
Nice wee sleep. Eh? A nice wee naparoo. I jerk my head.
Paragon just looks at her and shrugs. Like,
he looks at you and says, I could fight for you.
Put him to fucking sleep!
Wait, what? Wait, what?
Knock him out.
You could fight for us?
So he says, I could fight for you. And then there's a... As Mork.
Because Roswell yelled, put him to fucking sleep! So I'm like, Jesus okay.
Roll me an attack. Roll me an attack.
Be gentle.
I don't think Mork can
be
gentle.
Oh my god. Come on.
You swack him over the head and he goes down. Lights out.
He's unconscious.
My hand really hurts. I punched myself really hard.
Why did you do that?
Ow. I was gesturing the hit and it hurt my hand. I had to stop myself before I hit the computer screen.
Oh, fair enough.
Okay, so you knock him out just as he's offering to help you and he goes down like sack of shit.
Oh, jeez.
He's asleep.
All right. I pull the blanket up over him.
Really, how we would have got from him was me being out there.
Why are we actively working against our best interests here?
Alright, let's go.
Paragon has wondered that since the game has started.
Everyone's yelling to put him to sleep, so I put him to sleep. Why is there...
We're not working against our best interests. But let's go north. Or south. What do you guys think?
West.
North.
West is a wall.
I will give you the direction so you can tell which way is actually up.
Oh, is she looking at your map?
No. She's still wrong. There is no west.
I'm not that bad at frickin' metagaming. Jeez.
You're better than Adam, then.
Yeah. He can't sit next to me because he just does look. Okay. All
right.
So, before you guys head off, we will take our first break here. We'll take 10 minutes and we will come back.
Excellent. I need to go throw up again.
Okay. All right, see you very soon, Twitch. Bye-bye. Welcome back. Hello, people that are fortunate enough to still be here. We are back, and we'll stop talking about old people that Thok would like to have babies with.
I'd fuck Audrey Hepburn.
The answer is all
you'd fuck Audrey Hepburn. Isn't she dead?
Dead.
That's fine.
Some of these people can't have babies anymore, Thok. Just putting it out there.
I know. That's what, man.
So, moving along from that conversation, not coming back to it.
The under the berry this week.
The group has descended down into the ice tunnels below the town of Oyavigaton. Now what?
You tell us, buddy.
No, I'm waiting for you. Which way are you going to go? You have a tunnel stretching up to the north.
You haven't told us and a tunnel... which is north, east, south, and west yet.
Really? Because on the map, there's a big blue section with an N pointing up.
I was boomed in fast.
Okay. So, the light in this tunnel, it is very well lit. And the reason for this being, if you look up, you can see that above you, the ice seems to glow with the sunlight. And you figure that... the reflection of the sun on the spire is lighting up the inside through the clear ice that surrounds you.
Oh, that's
so nice. There's no torches, there's no lamps, but everything is filled with refractory light. It is quite beautiful. Now, where would you like to go?
Spire hollow all the way up, or is it like...
You can see, so this bit of ice that you came down, that's the stairs, it's got like a shaft of ice around it, but... outside of that, the stretch is far up into the ceiling, like quite a ways.
Cool.
Can I make a horn noise?
Oh, what God. Sort of horn noise?
Just a horn noise with my mouth.
Like that sort of horn?
I don't know. Like, can I? If like if I make a horn noise, does it sound like the Drake horn?
Roll you do it.
Check.
No, you don't need to roll for
it. Can I give him inspiration?
You can make a horn thing. You do. It doesn't echo deeply. You lack the ability to make it sound as loud as a horn would. So you get a slight echo and then silence. It doesn't seem to recreate the noise of the Drakehorn.
Did you try to cause trouble?
I thought maybe this tower was the Drakehorn.
Not a terrible idea.
So, guys, I know that we're looking for this horn, but I believe the whole orcishly that if we find this dragon, we're going to die a terrible, terrible death.
Okay, but what a fight it would be.
We'll find the horn first.
Yeah, if we even see hint of a dragon, we're going to bail out, okay?
Aye, that seems fair.
And there is a low rump now.
I didn't know you were such a coward, Thok.
Oh!
My daddy taught me the difference between bravery and stupidity.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. Mark didn't have a daddy. Let's go north.
He did. He had an adopted daddy.
So, before you decide which direction, you do see that north goes into a tunnel that goes in a left and right split. And you see that south, the tunnel goes into what appears to be some sort of larder.
Wait, I'm not playing Eleanor, so I'm not interested.
Hang on, Lisa's just going to restart. She's having connection issues, but we can continue on, and I'll just relay anything to her for the next couple of minutes. So I didn't catch what the last thing you said was after I told you that there was like a lottery room. You can see more supplies and stuff just through that doorway.
It's just shite. Okay, well, I guess probably let's go south then, so we can, like, walk through the larder on our way to whatever.
Are you feeling hungry, Iona?
No, that's Eleanor, not Iona.
Right, Iona doesn't eat.
Iona she's but a pixie. Like a single mouthful of food will fill her tum-tum. So...
well, her mouthful, because...
No,
like...
shh. Yes, she has a massive head. Big, dumb caricature head.
I doubt it's not canon.
Okay, so you head into the larder, and you see down here a lot of supplies. There's a lot of frozen fish, whale, seal, walrus, other, you know, sea life from this area. You also see some furs. Some of the furs don't look like person-sized. So they've been converted into clothing, I should say, sorry. And right. Some of the clothing doesn't look person-sized. People furs.
I'm glad you knew what I was thinking.
Yeah. You also see some shells, bones, soft, curious stones, and other sundries, such as inks, brushes, parchment. There's a few seemingly inexplicable items stored amongst, like a single gauntlet, or a silver brooch, or a brass hilt of a knife without a blade attached, and like a decorative belt buckle just sitting on the floor. Just random shit that looks like it might have been pulled from the stomach of sharks or giant fish that the ice hunters have killed. But all of it's stockpiled down here. You also see some things that might be of use. You see some coils of rope, some climbing spikes, and a pulley set with ropes and pulleys. Basically a kit that's set for ice climbing, but maybe only for one person. And it's very clear that this gear has not been made by the ice hunters. This sort of machinery-made stuff or well-made stuff is beyond the technology you saw up above.
I'm extremely good at climbing. I'd like to take this climbing gear.
Okay, so you take the climbing gear. Chuck in your inventory, pulleys, climbing spikes, and 100 feet of rope.
Yeah! Wait, is that in the book?
What?
Or do I have to add it myself? Or is
yes.
It
you should book? Already have
the... It's not in a parcel for me to give out, but it is in the book.
Okay. I do have 50 feet, but now I have 150 feet. Yeah!
Awesome.
Nice.
Oh, wait, no, I don't actually have that 50 feet because I used it to make a raft.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So, to the door to the left, as well, standing in here, you can see that the next room has items too, but rather than things of use, you see, even from here, a pile of junk, food scraps, a waste, clothing that's torn and wrecked. It looks like the sort of the rubbish pit. And it's a couple of feet deep.
Hello.
Welcome back.
Hello.
Can you, what, Iona? Sorry, what were you saying? You cut out.
Hello? Iona?
She's dropped off, by the way.
She's gone.
Because
Discord is shit.
No. It's,
Discord is
shit. You're shit. Shut up. I'm in stream mode, so I don't hear the room leave modes. Okay, so she would like to do nothing. What does the rest of the group do?
I don't know what's happening.
You guys
you go through the other tunnel.
You guys are in the ladder. No, sorry, you're not in the ladder. You're in the... you're on the ladder. Looking, you can see the next room along is like a rubbish pit. The room you're in is like a storeroom, and Thok's just gathered some climbing gear. The other tunnel heads southish. Let me just reveal it. You see, go shortly into another room, and you feel a biting chill flowing from that room ahead. Wemmy's back.
Sorry about that. My Discord crashed. Should we look through the rubbish pit?
What would you want to like investigate? Have a look around.
Yeah. Just to get, you know, what kind of rubbish is it?
Okay, roll me an investigation check.
Yeah, cool.
So you're really a womble.
My cousin's a womble.
So you start having a look around and explore through, and you start throwing little burger containers and shit around. It's all pretty much useless junk. You don't find anything of value. Just 2 to 3 feet in places, 2 to 3 feet deep in places of rubbish completely in this room. You do see a door heading out.
Oh, like inside. A secret door?
No, you just see the door.
Oh, I see. Another door. Well, it was secret until we found it.
Now, as you're looking around, though, you do hear some strange noises coming from this doorway. Can you roll me a perception check, please? Sure, you're currently in
sure
pixie
thing,
form?
Chief. Yeah.
Okay. You hear some... What languages do you speak?
Sylvian and Common.
Okay. You hear some language that you don't understand, but you recognize as Draconic. Hear some low...
Oh.
By the way, shouldn't I speak Draconic by now? Because I spent, like, since the fucking cart studying it.
Did you?
Yeah. You said you were studying it while you were off, I remember. Like, during your break.
Okay. Yes?
Oh, yeah.
Would you like to come up and hazard a listen?
I would silently.
Okay. Yeah. You can easily get to the doorway without making any noise. And you can hear this Draconic tittering as well. You can't make anything out. It is a little bit like there's quite a few voices. You can't clearly make things out. You need to get closer to here. And that would be going down into this room. But you can definitely hear multiple voices speaking Draconic.
Do you know what? I'm gonna stealth in and see if see what is going on and report back, please.
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, let me put you on the map, people. So Thok is standing at this doorway. Mork, is everyone else in the rubbish room as well? Has everyone else stepped up?
No, yeah. Sure, why not?
You can say no. You don't have to.
Said yes, okay?
Fuck. Where's everybody else? Where's Desona? That is everyone. Pagon, you in the rubbish room?
Yeah.
Okay. Roll me a stealth check, please, Iona.
Cool. I'll do that.
Have
she is going into the room to try and see what's in there.
Oh, thanks, buddy. Okay, I use his inspiration.
It's an apology for snaking your heel.
Can I go with her and stealth?
Yep, you can roll stealth as well.
In the tower or normal?
In the tower. Holy shit, Iona.
What?
How do you bad so much?
If I got a good roll, can I help her?
Right.
No.
I thought you, that's how it works.
Only in group stealth. The two of you going down a tunnel isn't group stealth.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
No, it's a group of two.
What did she roll? Oh, Pargon, you're useless. Go away. Oh, they're getting better.
Why am I useless?
Because I saw 13 and then you kept rolling. But that's.
Well, I'm not going. Yeah. I'm just standing here.
Neither am I. I'm less like, yep.
Oh, you got a plus 10 as well. So do I.
Okay, so. You two start heading down the hall and you come into this room and you see ahead of you 12 kobolds sitting around.
Yes.
Fucking kobolds.
They're all tittering around. Some of them are arguing about something held between the two of them. One of them's pulling one way. One of them's pulling the other. They're arguing back and forth. Unfortunately, the one that speaks Draconic did not come with you, so you can't make out any of the other discussion. But yeah, there is about 12 kobolds that are talking, yarning, fighting, throwing food, throwing shit. Just fucking around. You also see around here, there's a number of what are effectively beds for these kobolds. And it appears that this is the kobold's den. This is where they are living down here. There's half-eaten fish heads and seal flippers and other bits of animals tossed into corners, strewn around. Matted furs lay on each of these little bed pits, and the smell is horrendous.
I feel another genocide coming.
Well, really, this town is made out of dragon cultists.
You also see two of them sitting in the southernmost corner, rolling knuckle bones in some sort of game.
I rolled a 16 on my stealth. Can I move in a little bit?
No, your stealth isn't rolling the tower.
You tell me to roll.
All stealth in the tower, mate. Going. All stealth is in the tower.
Who wants to try to talk to me?
You two move up, and after a few seconds, Thuck's like, you know what, I've had enough of this. And he goes to move up, and he steps off this heap of rubbish, loses his footing, stumbles, and slides down between the two of you, poof, right into the center, with his as all of the kobolds turn to look at this stumbling mess, flanked on either side by Rosalind and Iona.
I clap slowly.
Good thinking, Pargon.
Fuck.
Good thinking.
Fuck. Mork sees him falls, begins to move up. Pargon, too, begins to move up. Everyone please roll initiative as these kobolds flip whatever tables they don't have, throw the knuckle bones to the ground, and begin to get ready and fight.
Net 20!
Rosalind, you have ambuscade, so you have your turn.
I do. Next to the sparse, that's right.
So you get two turns right now.
Can I still use my bow? Like, he's far away enough, eh? No disadvantage?
Nope. It's only if they're within melee range.
You should really kill the far away ones so the melee can actually...
Yeah, you shouldn't kill...
Oh, that's a good idea.
Shouldn't kill people that are 2 feet away. Or two squares away, I should say. You have like 600 range. You can shoot anyone in this room.
You can shoot anyone on this glacier.
Just shoot that guy first.
Okay.
I don't like him.
Roll your attack.
Net 20! Oh!
Are
Double
you like damage cheating?
Yet. How?
Cheating going on?
Computer.
I can cheat, but no. I don't. Hang on.
Sorry. I mean, damn it.
Okay, so the arrow flies out. Let's see if it survives before this effect is read. Cause...
Okay, do I need to press my thing? Or have I
no, you've already done it. Roll damage. Yeah, he dies. 45 points of damage.
It didn't exceed them.
It's well, actually surprised as well. Oh, no, you already rolled critical, right. It doesn't even matter. So if it had survived that, the arrow you fired broke the supersonic sound barrier, and it was deafened for the next round.
Wow.
I have no idea. It was deafened for a round. It's the only thing I can think of for an arrow deafening someone. Unless you hit shot them through the... Yeah, they've got two ears, motherfucker. If it went right through... I suppose it did. You burst both eardrums, and in doing so, you skewered its brain and it died.
Yeah.
Good work. All right. So now it is your turn again. Now, do remember, you don't get your sneak attack unless you have someone within 5 feet or advantage on the roll. You don't have someone within 5 feet of any target.
Isn't that the one close? Is it?
Nope.
Close to me?
Nope. The target.
How it's 10 feet away from you, and then.
Can I use my sharpshooter then?
Okay, take your minus. So that's a 12, which will still hit.
Yeah.
Actually, but I'm going to make you re-roll damage. That. Re-roll that.
Okay. Can you take off that sneak attack somehow?
Mm-hmm. Just re-roll the sharpshooter. And you miss.
Oh, thanks.
No, you just need to call it before you roll to take it off. It's not fair. So you miss the shot of the next one. And that is all for your turn. Or do you want to move?
I should have just sat back, sorry.
Why, we would have come in here and murdered them all anyway, at least you
I know, like, you're the only one who could have heard them anyway.
I understand Draconic, but...
Mate, it's not you, it's the dice.
No.
It's the dice.
No, I mean, it's him.
Why do you insist on hurting me so bad? I just want to be your friend.
You always hurt the ones you love.
Oh.
Okay, I feel better now. Thank you.
That wasn't his intention.
Too bad. That's how I interpreted it.
You don't know my intentions. My intentions are to fucking go to sleep. That's what my intentions are.
You're struggling a bit there, buddy.
Fucking tired.
I went to sleep at like 5 o'clock in the morning.
Sorry, 2 hours ago.
I'm fucking tired too.
Yeah, but you're doped up on Valium.
Yeah, just a little bit.
The price we pay for living on the right continent. I mean, hemisphere.
The right continent is like, you guys live on different continents. I'm not quite sure.
At least my ankle doesn't hurt anymore.
Can you feel anything at all?
Happiness feeling?
I don't know what happiness is.
Have some Valium. It sounds great.
I have some Lauricet in my medicine cabinet.
What's Lauricet?
It's like drugs.
Lauricet. What does it do?
Lauricet.
Opioid.
Lauricet.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Hey, that was one left.
Right.
Hey, yeah. I should just start smoking opium. That'll block me up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Just you know, start a crippling heroin habit.
All right. Yeah, sounds like a good plan.
Actually, no, don't, because don't do it. don't do it. That's bad.
Actually, don't. But my poop though.
Don't.
Does heroin help your poop?
Told you, man. Just
yeah. Opioids give you constipation as a side effect.
Yeah, yeah, but
don't worry.
So do many painkillers. So
Kevin's already very familiar with eating cock.
What?
What? What the fuck?
Where did that come from?
Never mind.
It was a solid joke.
Because
I said you should eat some caulking, and he said you're very familiar with eating cock.
Oh, I missed the first part. That's why it wasn't funny. That for me and Mork there, I think that came out of the blue, where he's just like, Kevin likes to eat cock. It's like, what?
just in general. Well,
no, right, it was a top tier Raz.
All right, good job, Thok.
I did it. I'm the best.
Now go to like go some no-nos, bro, and you'll be fucking tripping balls.
I just want to go to bed.
Yeah, because you want to sleep so bad that you can't because you're like wired as the worst.
I'll steer your character.
Sorry, guys, just on a phone call.
Thank you. Oh, no worries, dude.
Yeah, we're good. It's cool, man.
We're making our own D&Ds.
Yeah, I'm not just up at like 4 a.m. and
I don't care about you guys. I'm talking to the stream. Fuck.
Wow. That hurt me.
You should be used to pain by now, buddy.
I don't feel anything.
Joy on a nice morning when it's cool outside and the sun's just coming up. Feels good, man.
No, there's not that in Florida. It's never cool outside.
Oh, yeah, do. I'm sure you feel contempt there, buddy. Contempt is a feeling.
I got that morning's full of like Zika virus and shit. That's what I got. There's a Zika outbreak in Florida now.
Really?
Yeah, we know. Yeah.
You better not give birth, otherwise your children have.
It's okay. I never go outside, so I'm safe.
I don't know. I don't know about long term effects, but the babies with the microcephaly are still adorable, so it's okay.
Yeah.
I think babies are shit, so.
Well, that's because.
I don't think I'll be getting pregnant anytime.
Well, that's probably it'll not just a concern.
It'll be just like the flu for me if I get it, so I'm not actually worried.
Well, I mean, God forbid there's a junior situation. You just be careful.
Yep.
And you know, isn't Florida full of Trump supporters anyway? So really,
yeah, it's basically a benefit.
Actually, because of the recent polls, Hillary Clinton is actually winning in Florida.
Well, Jesus Christ.
Are you sure it wasn't Trump a misstep? Because I miscounted.
Well, Trump's fucking up like even worse now.
Yeah, Trump is
getting harder and harder to support.
He's had a terrible fucking 2 weeks. Like, fighting with a Gold Star family was the
dumbest shit. He's had like a terrible 9 months.
Yeah.
He's a terrible person is what he is.
He's doing things that the super right wing actually don't like.
Yeah.
Rather than just doing awful, horrific things that they do like.
Like, he straight up said he would consider nuking European countries, and people weren't very happy about
that.
Well,
maybe he was thinking of Turkey, because Turkey's technically European.
No, it isn't.
No, it's not.
I mean,
I'm pretty sure
I mean, it is. It's well, I think it's Asia, actually.
Yeah, it's not in the EU.
Isn't it?
No, absolutely not.
Oh, no.
Turkey's not in fucking... They're, like, in NATO, I think.
Oh, NATO. Yeah,
they're in NATO.
Yeah. Which is pretty much the EU.
No, you need to, fulfill so many prerequisites of human rights and, like...
Your so, how the hell did Greece get in there?
Well, what do you mean?
Just in general.
Do you know?
Greece used to not be terrible, but then they were terrible.
All that happened with Greece is that they just overspent.
Well, I mean, to be fair, you're not in the EU.
No, there's no human rights in Scotland, obviously.
We're still in the EU for another 2 years.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
because
Article 50 gives you 2 years to disengage, because you can't just immediately stop being in the EU.
What if you get kicked out? Does it take 2 years to kick you out?
Yeah, I think so.
That's...
God. You also have stupid fuckers in your country.
Fucking don't even get me started. I don't even want to be part of this country. What a joke. Everyone in Scotland was just like, what?
You should come move to the US where everyone's like logical and rational and wouldn't ever vote for that kind of shit. On the scare of like immigration and foreigners. No one in America is scared of that shit for no reason.
Oh, but Lizzie, did you know Trump said that Scotland voted to leave?
Yeah, I know.
I mean,
he was
people
here
in
when
Scotland
he
voted to leave. So.
Oh my goodness.
Scotland has failed as a country by not just shooting Trump in the face when he got there.
I know. We've got really
strict. Didn't that British dude try to shoot him at a convention or something?
Yeah, an illegal British immigrant tried to kill him.
That's fucking funny.
Like,
it is. It's pretty funny.
Oh,
should have pulled himself up by his bootstraps and shot him better.
Okay, guys, yeah. I need to call for the night, 45 minutes early. I'm really sorry, but I need to head off. So thanks, everyone, for watching and bearing with us the last 15 minutes of good politics. Thanks, everyone, for coming. And if you guys are on later on, I'll catch you. Otherwise, I will see people for tomorrow's game tomorrow, and we'll continue on with this next week. Once again, sorry for cutting off early.
We're doing it next week?
Shit, you're right. Next week we are off for this session. We'll still have the following game, so tomorrow's game next week. But yeah, this one, I am on evenings, so I won't be able to DM. Thanks for reminding me, so I can remind you.
All right.
Okay, I love you.
Good luck with whatever that is.
Okay.
Yeah,
bye.
No worries, buddy.